In this video, I'm going to show you my portrait workflow, as well as give you some tips on using Luminar's AI retouching tools. What's up, friends? Welcome to another tutorial. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you my kind of overall portrait workflow. Okay, so we're going to begin in Lightroom and then go to Luminar. Now, I have Lightroom here loaded up. What I would say is go ahead and download the exercise file. I'm going to include the raw exercise file in case you guys would like to follow along with this exact tutorial. So here's the deal. I still like to use Lightroom as my basic raw processor in my workflow. And Luminar is incredibly powerful and it can do most of the same things. The reason why I like to do this and why you might like to do this is because I've already spent a lot of time and money investing in presets or creating my own looks inside of Lightroom. And I would guess that most of you are probably the same. So here's what we're gonna do. This image is completely reset out. I'm gonna go ahead and select Visual Flow Modern Pack, the soft light preset. Now this single click basically gets everything the way I like. All I'm gonna do is dial the exposure down just a tiny, tiny bit, and we're good to go. So you can use any presets you like, you can develop however you like, but I like to begin here, process everything a certain way, and then I'm gonna right click and go edit in and then Luminar 4. Now if you wanna change or control how you get from Lightroom to Luminar, you can actually do that in your preferences by pressing Control comma. Okay, so right here we can see our external editing tab. If we go down to additional external editor, we can actually set up a custom preset, and I have it set to Luminar 4, and I've set my basic adjustments, right? So JPEG, sRGB, 8-bit, this is the file that I wanna take there. The reason why I want it to be full resolution or 300 DPI is because I wanna do all my retouching and have a printable image there. Then if I want to export to a smaller size, I'll do that. But I don't wanna bring smaller files into Luminar and then have to do, you know, two different file sizes. I wanna just have one finished edit and call it good to go. So once you've done that, you can right click, go to edit in, and then our preset shows up and it goes straight with those copy file options, okay? So now we're gonna give Luminar just a second to load up. All right, so we're in Luminar and I wanna do a couple things. So I want to first show you kind of how I like to use the tools, but we're also gonna save out a preset, which is kind of generic enough that we can apply and use over all of our images. So let's go ahead and jump into the portrait panel. And what I'm gonna do is first pull up the AI skin enhancer. Now, here's the deal. I love the AI skin defect removal, okay? But I don't generally like to turn this on a preset that's gonna be applied to a large variety of images. And the reason why, as you can see on certain images like this, the cloning might sometimes pick up patterns and textures in clothing and kind of create unwanted results, right? So usually I'll leave that off, but what I do use is the AI skin enhancer. This is gonna detect the skin tones and it's gonna automatically make adjustments. Now, what I like to do here is zoom into kind of an area of texture and increase the amount where the texture is not removed. If I go up to 100%, it kind of kills and makes things look a little bit too plasticky, right? A little bit too perfect. So what I like personally, if I'm gonna apply it to all my images, is I like to dial this back to maybe like 40 to 50. And this gives me a nice smoothing look without going over the top, okay? I'll also usually include a little bit of shine removal. Now again, if you go up too much on any of these, it can end up with kind of a porcelain-like look to the image. But I'm gonna go ahead and bring this up to 15. There's not a lot of shine on this image because, well, it was shot with very soft light to begin with. So because it was shot with soft light, we're not gonna notice it, but that's what I like to do to build that into my look, okay? Now let's go to the AI Portrait Enhancer. I love, love, love this face light option. This is gonna add light directly to the faces of the image. The trick here though, is you don't wanna go too high because if the image is bright to begin with, it can be too much, right? It's a little over the top. So what I like to do is go somewhere around 20. And what this does is it just adds a nice little kind of dodge look to the face, which lifts the face out of the image, and keeping it subtle makes it something that I could apply to literally everything. Red eye removal, we're generally not using flash, so I'm usually leaving this off. Or we're not using direct flash to create red eye. We're usually using bounce flash or off-camera lighting. But if you do notice that in your images regularly, turn it on. eye whitening. I love this little guy, okay? Watch this. As soon as I turn this up, you can see it start to whiten the image. Now, how do you know when you've gone too far? Well, look, what we're gonna do is actually zoom out. If we can zoom out on this even further, let's see, it won't let us. Let's do it where, okay. This is the furthest that we can get zoomed out, right? So what I want you to do is to kind of zoom in first and make your adjustment here to kind of a place where you think it looks natural. Then what you're gonna do, I'm gonna use the mouse wheel just to zoom back out, and we're gonna look at it from the wide view. Now, if from this wide view, it looks like the eyes are popping out unnaturally, dial it down, okay? So it kind of has this alien eye look if when we're up here, where it looks like the whites in the eyes just stand out too much. I don't like going up that high because it looks unnatural. So again, I like to keep this around 30 to 35. The eye enhancer is the same thing. This is gonna enhance like irises and that kind of stuff, right? So again, we want this nice little balance here where we're not gonna go too high. We're just gonna see a nice pop there that looks very subtle. Okay, dark circle removal. We can take this up and be pretty safe. The only thing here is if you take it up really, really high, it can affect the bottom whites of the eyes just a little bit. So again, I like to kind of leave this more of like a diminishing tool rather than like a tool to kind of remove, right? So I wanna always think diminish, don't think remove. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and zoom back in, okay? Now I'm gonna close my eyes, get my little palette cleanser, zoom back out, and see if it pops in an unnatural way. And I do see a little bit too much whites, so I'm gonna go ahead and just reduce the whites down to 30, and I like the iris where it's at, everything else is good. Okay, so here's where we get to slim face. Now, if we slim the face, you'll notice that it does a really great job of targeting it. The only thing is, I generally don't like to do this across images unless a client asks. If a client asks, will you slim down my face, then by all means, like, that's fine. But otherwise, if you make these kind of adjustments, it can, one, it can cause them to look a little bit unnatural, and two, it's kind of like, who am I to decide whether their faces should be slimmed? I think everyone looks great the way that they are. If they choose that they want something done, then by all means, I'll do a little bit. But on this, you can stay pretty safe on applying this generally to all images at, say, 5 to 10 strength. Anywhere, if you're going anywhere higher than this, I would really do it on an image-to-image basis because going high can make faces look quite odd, okay? Same thing with enlarged eyes, okay? Going a little bit, like say at a 10, it's not gonna be too big of a difference, it's not gonna be hugely noticeable. But if you start really expanding eyes up there, it really gets cartoony and kind of unusual, okay? Although I am very impressed in how well it targets everything. So usually I leave those off. Improve eyebrows, this one's funny to me, because it's like, improving eyebrows is very, it kind of is subjective to me. Like, how do you objectively improve your eyebrows? Apparently, the developers of Skylum would all agree that you improve eyebrows by darkening them, which I don't know. I don't personally know, but I think it's awesome. So what I'm gonna do is just add like maybe plus 10 to like kind of darken a little bit here. I might add a little bit of lip saturation, okay? A little bit of redness to the lips, just to get a little more pink. Lip darkening, we don't really need to go too much. Sometimes I like to do a little bit just to give it a tiny bit more tone. And then teeth whitening, we wanna be careful with again, okay? So she already has very white teeth. So again, if we're gonna do something like this, we're gonna put it like a small amount that would be nice for all images. So why do I wanna save this or why do I wanna create a look for all images? Because I'm actually gonna save this as a new look, okay? So you'll notice that I already have one. It's Pi's general portrait, and that's exactly what we've essentially done here. I would call this like Pi's portrait starter. And I'm gonna save this out, and you guys can call this whatever you want. But I would save this out, and this would be my baseline that I could literally apply to every image that I export. And look at the before and after. It's substantial, but it's done in a very nice way. So if I kind of go and click into this a little bit, look at this, okay? That's a nice difference, and it's nice, and overall, it doesn't look like it's gonna be kind of obnoxious, right? So what I would do at that point is then, once I've exported all my images from Lightroom, and we're gonna do a full length tutorial on this for the SR Lounge YouTube channel, then what I would do is open up Luminar as a standalone application and apply that to all the images. So how would I do that? Well, watch, I'm gonna go ahead and pull up Luminar 4 because this is the Luminar plugin, right? So this is the plugin that works in conjunction with Lightroom, which is great when you just wanna work on one image or if you wanna create a look or a preset. From here though, I can actually go to File, go to batch processing, and I can select an entire folder. So once I've selected a folder, let's just choose one. For example, I'm gonna choose this desktop folder. We'll use this one, okay? And I would select all my images, press open, and then I can actually use my presets that I had defined, okay? So again, once I get to the look, all I'm gonna do is choose Pi Portrait Starter. And I can apply this in whatever amount, and I can apply it to every image and batch retouch an entire set of 100 images and just let the computer go. And you'd get beautiful final results each and every time, okay? So that's what I like to do in terms of my portrait retouching workflow. And then if necessary, if I have clients that want more than just what was done with this image, then I would do that as needed, say in Photoshop if I have to, or in Luminar on an as needed basis. But this is the place where I get to what I would call a final product. And this is how we would deliver our images to our clients. Hopefully this helps you all out. Hopefully you see how easy it is to batch retouch an entire set of images and how I like to kind of set up the retouching preset itself. That's it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, I'd love for you to like the video, subscribe to this channel, and please, please, please comment below. I love seeing your guys' comments because it gives me ideas on what tutorials and what videos to create as we go forward. So I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.